Hello ladies and gentlemen, this is Vedant from Communicate, and today in this video we are going to see what are rich message buttons and how you can create them from Dialogflow. So rich message buttons are used for a variety of cases such as setting up surveys, appointment, booking flight, train tickets and for booking movie, event tickets, etc. Rich messaging boosts customer conversation. Another benefit of rich message buttons is that users can easily interact with your business. Using rich message, we can provide the user with a specific set of instructions to reduce errors in spellings and make it easy for our bots to understand queries and reply to the same efficiently. So in this tutorial, we are going to see how to create link buttons and suggested replies. To create these buttons, you need to integrate Communicate with Dialogflow. Assuming that you have already done that, if you haven't, then here is a card to another video. Click this and watch the simple tutorial of how you can integrate Communicate with Dialogflow. All the links will be available in the description box below too. So once you have done that, we can proceed to the main agenda, link buttons. So now you need to log into your Dialogflow console and click on intents. Then click on new intents. Here we have some already created intents as we can see. So now give your intent a name, and after it, you need to give training phrases. These are the phrases of words which will trigger your intent, and under responses, you can add what the bot is going to deliver as a response to the user. Simply click on add response to create new responses. So now, let's see how you can create link buttons. These are the types that we are going to create in this tutorial. So we already have rich buttons created over here. So let's see how you can do it. First, you need to add some training phrases. I have already created two training phrases. One is link button and the other one is where can I find the link buttons. So for those phrases, we have created a text response and custom payload. Metadata and content type are necessary, so don't remove these from the script. So in our case, we have given two links. Name is what the user will see as a link button name. Then type tells us that it's a link. And then in the link, you'll mention the link where this button will redirect the user to. You can also put an open link in the new tab with the value true, if you want this link to open in a new tab. So now you can just go to your bot and type your training phrase. It is going to respond with your given response, which are your link buttons. So this is how you can create link buttons. Quite easy, right? Now let's see how to create suggested replies. So similarly for this one also, create a new intent and mention your training phases. These are the ones which we have mentioned, and then again the same process of adding responses. We have added a text response check our teams with custom payload. So in custom payload, the platform should be set to Communicate. You can give a message to display to the user. This is optional. Again, metadata part is important. Then here is the name of suggested replies and messages for that reply once it is clicked. Now let's go back to a bot and type the training phase and see if it responds. So as you can see, the bot has responded with what responses we mentioned: tech team and sales team. Now, once a user clicks suggested replies, you can create follow-up intents, just like here we are having two follow-up intents for this particular suggested reply intent. In follow-up intent, also the process is quite similar. In training phase, we just have tech team, as that is what main intent is going to reply with. And then in response, we have this script again, where again metadata is important, and inside assign to either you can put an agent's email or leave it as it is, and it will get assigned to the next online agent. Under the message, you can put whatever you want to show to the user. The same is for sales follow-up intent. You can create multiple intents and follow-up intents like this. Now, that is it for this video. To see more button types and their codes, you can visit Communicate's documentation page, and under rich messages, you can find these buttons with their codes. Now, if you loved the video, please hit that like button and subscribe to our channel. This is Vedant from Communicate, signing off. See you in the next one.